Hello and welcome to another Japanese from Zero. This is Hitokoto. Hitokoto is where we take one Japanese concept and we look at that. Sort of an advanced concept, not a basic concept. So this is for people that already know some Japanese and are trying to spice it up a little bit with adding things that either they don't know or that they've heard and don't understand. So let's look at masaka. Today's topic is masaka. Masaka in the dictionary has a lot of different meanings. There's a lot of different nuanced ways to think about it. But what we're going to be doing it today, what we're going to be doing with it today is more like thinking of it as like no way. A lot of times when you learn advanced Japanese, if you're in a class, for example, if you're in a good class, there will be no English even spoken and they will use Japanese to explain what this means. But I like giving you a basic meaning of it. It's no way. And the best way to see how it's used is to show how it's used in a sentence. Now, it's typically used in this kind of a pattern where it's masaka, something, 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 verb, nante, and they end it right there. So, masaka, suru nante. So with that basic sentence right there without anything else is, oh man, I can't even believe that they did that thing. Like, wow. It's when you're expressing a sort of shocking, like you don't believe it's even possible. It's almost like saying, no way, unbelievable. You can, for example, if somebody says something to you, like, hey, do you think Mariko would ever date you? Psst, masaka, no way, masaka, as if. It's like saying, as if, all right? All right, so let's look at a sentence that uses this. Let's say a person has been living in Japan for 10 years. This is exactly how I think when I meet people that have lived in Japan for 10 years and don't speak Japanese. I would say, masaka, 日本語が話せないなんて. Wow, just that they can't speak Japanese, wow. I mean, no way that they don't speak Japanese. This is, masaka. Masaka 日本語が話せないなんて. 思わなかった。I didn't even imagine it. 考えもしなかった。I didn't even think of it. 信じられない。I can't even believe it. Right? まさか日本語が話せないなんて。Alright? まさかチケットがそんなに高いなんて。And you can say 高い。I think you can even have だ in there, right? 高いだなんて。But I feel like... I'll have to look that up.Or you know what? You can look it up. You guys are advanced. I don't feel like it needs to be there at all, though. まさかチケットがそんなに高いなんて。So maybe your friend told you that they were going to go to an AKB48 concert, and the tickets were like 2万円. Well, that's really expensive, right? So you could say, まさかチケットがそんなに高いなんて。Wow, it's like, I can't believe that those tickets were that expensive, right? All right, and there's this one. Okay, wow, this is a weird one. We'll end on a story. A few years ago, I was looking up a friend named John, and John had done a video with me called John's Day with George, and he sort of did a behind the scenes here at the company. And at the end of the video, it said, now watch John's Day with George, or George's Day with John. And I thought, oh, that'd be cool. Now I'll go spend the day with John and we'll record it and it'll be funny. So I called him, but his phone number was disconnected, so I thought I'd look on the web for him. And I found a story about John, and he had killed his wife, which, by the way, was another YesJapan.com member, another member of our website. He had married her, and in the news article, it said he had killed her. He had stabbed her in the back with a knife, and then the next part of it was he put their dog in a microwave. It was like a small dog, put it in the microwave for an undetermined time, and the dog died. And when I first saw it, I thought, oh my God, that's hilarious that he would make that fake article on whatever this onion-style newspaper is. Turns out, it was real, and he's serving time. He's in jail now for, he only got 16 years, but they caught him at the Canadian border. And he had a defense wound that he made on himself, like he cut himself to look like he was defending himself. It's crazy because I knew both of them. I had met him, of course, when he came to film with me, and I had met him when he came up here for the last George and Keiko show. There used to be a show we did 1 million years ago called George and Keiko, and George and Keiko did like 100 episodes. It was an online Japanese topic show, and they came. nice guy, funny guy. I could totally be friends with him. And I thought about meeting him in jail or writing him a letter. But the thing is, you know, you don't know if it was a momentary moment that he killed somebody, or if he like totally became crazy, right? But if you look at any of the pictures that they show on the news, he looks crazy. So I'm a little bit scared. I was going to send him some Japanese books. I thought, you know, he's in prison for 16 years. But, you know, I wouldn't want him to become dependent on me. So I haven't talked to him. So this was made in honor of him, I guess. So it's, Masaka, denshi renji ni inu wo ireraru nante. Wow. I mean, no way. I just can't believe that he was able to put a dog in the microwave. All right. So that is it. So it's masaka. And I think you could change the verb form too. You could say, masaka denshi renji ni inu wo ireru nante. Wow. Putting a dog in the microwave. Unbelievable. Okay. And you can, and it's very common to just end on the nante. You don't have to have anything after it. The fact that it's an unbelievable thing or you can't imagine it happening, that is assumed, and you don't have to say the rest of the phrase. Less is more when you're speaking. The less you say and have, you know, with it's getting the same thing across is good. So don't try to say everything very, very long. Try to be very simple. And don't kill other people and don't put dogs in the microwave. All right, thank you for watching. Before we go, I want to say something that I never have done on the Japanese broadcast, but you guys that are very good in Japanese will be surprised to know that maybe, if you're not already studying Korean, I recommend these books, which I wrote with four other people, two Koreans and one American. We wrote this book together. We wrote all three of these books together, and they're really good. And the thing why I'm recommending it to you advanced users is that Japanese is very similar to Korean in grammar structure. So you already know 50% of what you need to know to learn Korean. You know how particles work. You know how order works for the sentences. And it's basically the same. So if you start learning Korean, I think you'll be very happy. If you're looking for something that's challenging, you know, go to KoreanFromZero.com and download the book for free. It's completely free. And if you're used to our style of book, it is that style of book. All right, I'll see you all on the next 一言。じゃあまた。